If you see how we are going to classify the butterfly valves, there are two categories based on which we can categorize all these butterfly valves. First one is as per body construction. Okay, then as per disc configuration. Based on body construction, we are having five types with us: wafer type, semi lug, lug type through and through bolts, lug type with body tap holes, threaded ones. Okay, then the flanged end type. These are the five types for which we have categorized based on as per construction, body construction. Okay, then another category is based on disc configuration, zero offset, which we call concentric type. Then under eccentric, we are having three types: single valve, double offset, then triple offset. Okay, if you see wafer type, looks like this. A very simple configuration, very thin, no flanges, only disc which is moving 90 degree in the valve body. Then semi lug type, we are having lugs here. Okay, lugs here, then again the disc is moving 90 degree inside the valve body. Then we are having lug type. Here we are having lugs all around, okay, through which we can put our studs also. So we'll having this through and through holes where studs will be moving and it will be connecting to the connecting flanges. Similarly, here we are having double flanged valve. This is the only valve, butterfly valve, where we are having flanged on both sides. In these cases, we don't have any flange. So that's why we have very compact design, very light design, and very economical design. So this one is a little bit costly as we are adding two flanges also. So this is the basic category based on body of construction. We are categorizing into these five types. This is very important section where we are categorizing based on disc configuration. If you see here, zero offset configuration, single offset configuration. Why it is zero configuration? Because the center line of disc and shaft is at same point. So there is no offset. Okay, so we call it concentric type butterfly valve. Here what we are doing, here the, if you see, this point is at center. If you see here, this point is not at center. That means we are offsetting it by some distance. Okay, so this is the offset distance from the shaft. That's why we are calling it single offset eccentric valve. Again, we have third category where we are doing the double offset. How we are doing the double offset? Here it was along the this line. Here we are offsetting from this point also. Again, we are not touching the body at center. This offset is there, this offset is there. So double offset we are having with the disc. Here we are having a third category with triple offset. How we are having triple offset? First this one, second this one, third one is with the sitting arrangement. This is at angle. Okay, this angle is at the causing the third offset. Okay, so based on this configuration, we are categorizing into four parts. Okay, now let us look at each of these section, all these valves one by one in detail in next slide. We'll have a pictorial view for each valve and how and why these offsets are required. Okay, we'll discuss in detail in next slide. In oil and gas fundas, knowledge sharing platform, we have covered all these topics. Time duration against each topic is mentioned here. Now in 2 minute funda part 1 series, we are going to cover 30 topics. I'm sure you're watching the HD and non-HD format along with the subtitles. So keep on watching, keep sharing knowledge.